Welcome to a video on exponential functions. The goals of this video will be to graph exponential functions and discuss some of the properties of exponential functions. An exponential function, f, is given by f of x is equal to b to the power of x, where x is any real number and b is greater than 0 and b cannot equal 1. The number b is called the base. And notice that they call it an exponential function because the variable is now in the position of the exponent. What we'll notice in a minute is if b is greater than 1, f of x is a positive increasing continuous function. In this case, f of x is called an exponential growth function. If b is between 0 and 1, f of x is a positive decreasing continuous function. In this case, f of x is called an exponential decay function. So here we have an exponential function in the form of f of x equals a to the power of x. And what we'll see is when a is between 0 and 1, our function is decreasing. Remember, decreasing means going downhill from left to right. Now you can see as a approaches 1, it's still decreasing, but it doesn't decrease quite as fast. Now part of the definition of an exponential function says that the base can't be 1. You can see if the base is equal to 1, you can see that we would have the constant function y equals 1. Now, as soon as the base a is greater than 1, the function changes to an increasing function. And as a increases, it increases even faster. In both cases, notice that the function is always positive, meaning always above the x-axis. It always has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. If there are no translations to the graph. And notice in this form, the y-intercept is always equal to 1. So again, the main thing here is when b is greater than 1, it's exponential growth. If b is between 0 and 1, we have exponential decay. Let's consider the graph of f of x equals 2 to the power of x. Just like any other function, if we want to graph it and we're not sure what it looks like, we make a t-table. So I've already picked values of x. Let's sub them in and find the corresponding y values. So if x is 0, we would have 2 to the power of 0, which is equal to 1. If x is equal to 1, we'd have 2 to the first, which is equal to 2. If x is 2, we'd have 2 to the second power, which is equal to 4. 2 to the third equals 8. 2 to the fourth equals 16. Now let's go ahead and try some negative values of x. Remember, 2 to the power of negative 1 is the same as 1 over 2 to the first, or 1 half. So if I have 2 to the power of negative 2, that's the same as 1 over 2 to the positive 2 power, or 1 fourth. Let's go ahead and plot these points. We have our y-intercept of 0, 1. Then we have the point 1, 2. 0.24, 0.38, and the 0.416 is off the screen, so let's go ahead and plot the point negative 1, 1 half, be somewhere in here, and the point negative 2, 1 fourth. Again, as x approaches negative infinity, the y value is approaching 0. Our function would look something like this. And we can see it goes up from left to right, so this would be exponential growth. Let's take a look at some of the characteristics of this graph. As mentioned earlier, notice the y-intercept is the point 0, 1. The limit of the function as x approaches negative infinity is equal to 0. So we have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. It's increasing over its entire domain, and it's also concave up. Now let's take a look at exponential decay. Let's consider the graph f of x is equal to 1 half raised to the power of x. Same idea here, we're going to raise 1 half to various powers. Of course, anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1. 1 half to the first power would be equal to 1 half. 1 half to the second would be 1 fourth. Here we're going to be a little more careful. We have 1 half to the power of negative 1. That's the same as 1 to the negative 1 over 2 to the negative 1. Which is equal to 2 to the positive 1 over 1 to the positive 1, which would actually give us 2. Let's try another. 1 half to the power of negative 2 would be the same as 1 to the negative 2 over 2 to the negative 2, which is the same as 2 squared over 1 squared, which would be 4, and so on. Of course, 1 to any power is always 1, so this would give us 8. Let's go ahead and stop here and plot these points. Point 0, 1, again, we have the same y-intercept in both cases. 1, 1/2, 2, 1/4. Now we have -1, 2, -2, 4, -3, 8. And you kind of see the pattern here. We can see this function goes downhill from left to right. So we classify this as exponential decay. Again, some of the key properties of this function. We have a y-intercept of 0, 1 again. The limit as x approaches positive infinity is equal to 0, so we have another horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. It's decreasing over its entire domain, and it's concave up. Of course, we could create these functions using our graphing calculator. I'll let you go ahead and try that if you wish, but we do want to be able to graph some basic functions without the use of a graphing calculator. Now let's take a moment and take a look at this function. F of x is equal to 2 raised to the power of negative x. Sometimes exponential decay can take this form, and what I want to show you that this is the same as f of x is equal to 1 half raised to the power of x. This would be the same as taking 2, raising it to the negative 1 power, and raising that to the power of x. And then, of course, we can rewrite 2 to the negative 1 as 1 half raised to the power of x. So f of x equal to 2 to the power of negative x is the same thing as taking 1 half and raising it to the power of x. Now, the reason I wanted to show you that, if we take a look at the graph of f of x is equal to 2 to the power of negative x and g of x equal to 2 to the power of x, you can see that these two functions have y-axis symmetry. Now, the reason I wanted to point this out, if we look at both graphs, remember that if we have the function g of x, and then we calculate g of negative x, the result is a reflection across the y-axis. We can see here, if we replace x with negative x, we can clearly see there is y-axis symmetry. Now, there are many real-life applications for exponential functions. Here's just a few. For exponential growth, there's population growth, bacteria growth, and even the growth of internet users. For exponential decay, we have situations like medication dosage and radioactive decay. I'd like to take a look at a website on population growth. The website that I'm going to show is intmath.com. What's neat about this website is it does give you a look at the world population, and you can see it changing as every second passes. What's neat about this is it tells you the rate of increase on the left, as well as information about how many people are added to the planet each second, day, and year. But you can also, if you want to, choose a different year, and you can see how dramatic the population levels are changing. As we move to 2020 and 2050, it gets rather scary. Now, of course, this is just a model, and every model has limitations. But this is a neat website you might want to spend some time exploring. Again, it's intmath.com. I hope this quick overview of how to graph exponential functions and some of their basic properties helped. Next, we'll take a look at how we're going to be finding the derivatives of exponential functions. Thank you for watching.